Halifax. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together as we welcome Al Jones.
Peace, everybody. I'm Al.
I'm sort of a product of the entire diaspora, so a mother from Trinidad. I'm here. It's through England. So I'm going to take us around where our people have been and give us a bit of history. I know y'all don't care. I'm going to start with this one. Let me tell you about my grandmother Zilla, the illest woman, a treasure, the realest. If I inherited one tenth of her strength, I'd be Atlas. I'd rather her blood in my veins than Cleopatra's. Trinidad bore her at the beginning of the 20th century. Offspring of a land of natural plenty where mangoes jostled in the yard with the breadfruit tree, wet seasons succeeding dry with regularity and safe from hurricanes harm by the mountain's protection. Truly, it was a place where God's promise seemed evident. Even for slaves, its beauty was heaven sent. Oh, why are we outcast in these Edens? Is it our destinies, inheritors of a world where we live as the enemy? Sacrifices in lands where we should be sacred, we go through this life little better than naked. Born onto this earth, Grandmummy gave it her labor and lived out her days a stranger to its fate. Grandmother Zilla, she raised 5 children. Granddaddy had a degree but couldn't work for a living. Hung out down at the panyard, beating a rhythm, went on month to month, never saving a shilling. Black woman, surviving the times is a miracle. Like a biblical soldier with a strength that was spiritual, everything a struggle, nothing was given. But on the dinner table she always had linen, and her daughter's hair there was always ribbon. Scraped up money somehow for their education, living in hopeless times. She never lost patience. Didn't feel she was degraded by her features or skin. How our people survive, you would hardly believe it. Descendants on an earth that deems us inferior, Grandmummy had nothing but said earthly goods are a burden. And when they needed white dresses for Easton, she used sheets and curtains. Times were tough then. The rich folk were thieving. It's a burning greed feeding those who have everything. Even the nothing we have is offending them, leading men to destroy the very flesh we conceive. So when her son was born, the doctors said leave him. He had water on the brain, so they said, don't bother. Told her he wouldn't even live to see 11, like the worth of his time on this earth was negligible. Who are they to call a human soul a vegetable? But Grandmummy, she knew how those doctors preach evil. What do they know of what love really is? Took him home and gave her the name of his father. You see how they try to tear families apart? Like water on the brain means you got ice in the heart. And what does it matter if you're a Negro or retarded? It's the same to some folks if ain't none of us human. Assuming the path of our lives is inevitable, black woman might as well give birth to a gorilla, but to Grandmother Zilla, all her children were beautiful. And by 3 days, her son outlived her, for the God that she praised to the end was merciful. Grandmother Zilla lived almost a century. She'd say God doesn't do nothing that wasn't meant to be. For most of her life, there were homes she couldn't enter, owned by people who called themselves gentlemen. She left her door open and made the homeless welcome. When they stole from her, she'd say, their need must be pressing, and hire them again when they came back around begging. Lived her life by the words that she found in the testaments, began and ended each day by counting her blessings. And never missed a carnival, right up to her deathbed. She loved to play mass, even though she was Methodist. The racism she saw, none of us will see the end of it. I'll be telling my grandchildren how to contend with it. So stories like these, they're not about sentiment. They're how we survive in a world of contempt for us. So let me tell you about my grandmother Zilla, the illest woman, a treasure, the realest, unbelievable, fearless, incredible will. On this whole earth, no soul shone out more brilliant. Thank you. This hair situation is an issue. I don't know what to do. I have to kind of grab at my hair periodically and hold papers and stuff, so sorry. All right, this one's for the youth, for our hip-hop generation. When we don't know where we come from and our history gets twisted, we end up what you see on BET.